Yeah, hello and welcome to the Bentablit Show. Let's get right into playing some games. So here we go. And no, I have the sound off. That's good. So let's get started here. And I have to cancel the Casper game first, and then see who's playing. Toki Madita. Let's play Toki Madita. Yeah, I'm sorry for a little bit of a rescheduling today. We originally should have started 90 minutes ago for the German show, but I couldn't quite do that. I needed to do some things for something that is probably quite apparent on the screen, you know, on the right hand side. You see a little picture there, and this is what I had to do. I had to still work for this opening course that's going to be released tomorrow, and at the last minute we had some things that needed to be done. So this is what happened, and I'm actually having a Sicilian on the board, which is good. Maybe I can show a little trigger or two how to play it. Oh, this is not so great. I'm winning the bishop here. Toki Madita has given me the bishop here for just a pawn. Yeah, is it okay? Do you hear me? Do you see me? All fine. Yeah, that picture is pretty good, yeah. You don't quite know if he's Bond or the Bond villain, yeah. Could also be the Bond villain. Well, actually, I should be the Bond villain, right? They always have those, German guys with the ball, with no hair, yeah. Like in Goldfinger and later, that was, who was that? Ernst Blofeld, right? Now, this should be pretty good, right? I can take h3 next. Very close to a checkmate on g2. Just need to get rid of the e3 knight, then it's made. Yeah, knight e2 is also a huge threat here, winning the queen. Okay, yeah, okay, let's win the queen. That is going to be enough. Yeah, he's only got one move, not much to think about. Yeah, or this one. So Toki Madita resigns. I was winning the queen here for not much. All right. So who else is challenging me? We have Area 51. Let's do that. So against d4, I play many things. I have a Norwegian challenge. I might only, of course, be a little joke, but there are many Norwegians playing now. Magnus has really drawn a bit of a crowd in his home country. Yeah, this is a line that I don't really know. I never studied it in any seriousness. It's probably not fantastic, but leads to interesting play. Fight Night Magnus is a new opening course. It's going to be released on Chessable, and it has a theoretical section. There is an interactive book, yeah, where you can learn the moves, and it also has a video part. It has 21 hours of video, so going to be a nice opportunity if you always wanted to play like the world champion in the opening. You can do so. Of course, we all fail later a little bit, But at least you get to enjoy the interesting positions that he gets with the Sicilian. Now, Area 51, he's probably just taking on h6, I guess. Wanted to get rid of the pawn. No, I've wrote the course. I didn't help to develop it. It's just 100% what I did. I recorded the videos, of course, and written every single word. The course, however, is officially endorsed by Magnus. It was sent to him and his team, and they approved of what I did. So we can be reasonably sure that I'm not writing any nonsense in there. If the world champion and Peter Heine Nielsen think it's good, I think we can be quite confident. Yeah. Now, what now? It's a bit of an odd position. A bit of an odd position. I don't quite know where I should develop my pieces. King in particular, a bit difficult to see where I should put it. And white, I mean, white is weak on the dark squares, but I don't quite get, I don't see how I get the queen in there. How do I ever get the queen here in play? Yeah, the queen should go to h4 or something like that. But I cannot really play the queen over. I don't know how. This is an odd idea. Maybe it's just a terrible idea. He's playing knight c4 anyway, right? I thought maybe go for knight g4 e3 ideas, but that's just not going to work. Yeah, that was a bad idea. Yeah, okay, go right back. That was just terrible. Queen d7. Very odd. It's a very odd position. I would be actually happy if he trades something. That gives me a little bit more space. Yeah, knight d7, bishop d7. That would be nice. No, it doesn't do it. Okay, but I can go b5 and play like that. If he takes, queen takes, I think this should be okay. Ah, he's got this check here. That could be a real problem. Huh. Is that a move? I don't know. It's really odd. It's a really odd position. I want to get the queen in here, yeah, queen g1, queen e3. Need to activate, and there's just 30 seconds. This is making it all a bit more. Okay, so I get this. Not sure if this is helping. The time will be most important here, I guess. Let's pin this. No, it's a mouse slip. Come on. I wanted to go queen f4. That's just unlucky. I mean, black's position is, of course, much better here if I go queen f4. But no time. And I really have to friggin' mute the software, otherwise I cannot do anything here. Just constantly irritated. Anyway, so let's get on with the next game. And who's challenging here, actually? Battery Bob? Free knight? Did I have a... Could I take a knight? Didn't see it. Okay, so Battery Bob, let's see what's going on here. So, yeah, this line I have advised to play in my Keep It Simple D4 repertoire. And yeah, this is the way to play. I can go A4 here. A couple of ideas that I can go for. And I don't know how to mute the software. I constantly keep getting messages here and I don't know how to stop them. I can completely mute the sound, but that will be irritating for me. Yeah, okay, let's just take E6. That's a simple way to do it. Oh, that looks odd. Giving up castling here, that looks really odd. Now, how do we play this? I can take B4 maybe. It's not urgent though. And I can go E5, it's also a possibility. Let's go E5 then. At the end of the day, the black king will always be a bit off. Yeah, just bishop d3, I guess. I need to castle, right? Castle, rook e1. Attack the knight. The knight on e4 actually has no square to go to. That could be problematic, right? What's annoying when you watch the show? Oh, okay, not mine. Yeah, I could go knight e5. That was also an interesting idea. I was just thinking e5 wins quite a bit of space, and I was thinking about this kind of situation where it's not so clear how the knight is going to be going away from e4. It just doesn't have a square. We'll see what happens. I'm castling and rook e1. That's the simple idea. Yeah, that's possible, but it's of course also a little bit weakening. Yeah, maybe this is a playable option for black. Okay, now I think I'm just castling. Not worried about bishop takes f3. The Magnus repertoire will be published tomorrow. Just tomorrow. This is why everything is a little bit short notice, so it's going to be out tomorrow. And will be on Chessable, but you will also see a very you will find it on Chess24 as well. This is all now being coordinated. I could have taken on c3, okay, possible. Okay, now back to this game. There was still some remarks about the game before. So I'm looking to pressure e6 here. This is all good, but it's not exactly fantastic. This makes it a bit more difficult for him to develop a5, because I have this. Now he takes. Okay. Yeah. Bishop to b7, something like that would be nice, but it's not easy to get. Yeah, this, it looks odd, black's position, but I don't currently see how I can make use of it. Yeah, that, I don't know, very dangerous pin. E5 looks risky, let's say. Yeah, now I can just go rook d1, right? Threatening rook, yeah, rook d7, no, it's possible. Bishop takes also was possible, but now I'm winning a couple of pieces. Yeah, and Battery Bob resigns. Yeah, the Black King was just under constant danger. And yeah. Okay, now who is challenging? Lex 2010. That's a new opponent. That's cool. So let's go Lex 2010. Yeah, the London system. This is a good way to play against it. Recently, I got a new book by Grandmaster Larry Kaufman, the Kaufman Repertoire, and he recommends this against the London, which was good to see because that is the same thing that I recommended some years ago in a chessable repertoire. And back then, I felt this is a really great line, and now finally, some recognition. Yeah, people play the same thing. How long did I work on Fight Like Magnus? That's tough to say in terms of hours. I do not really track this. I started with the outlines in July, and the largest part was written in September and October. And it is basically a full-time job, and that means more than like the 40 hours a week. We are talking about much more. So when I'm writing such a project, I'm basically doing absolutely nothing else. I'm just doing the writing, and the rest is secondary. I don't do anything else. So why can I not take? I think I'm on this enough. Think I can't win the pawn. So I got this. That's good. And I don't see much compensation. I mean, my position is a little bit odd, but it's not a big issue, I think. The queen on d6 is odd, but okay, yeah, you win a central pawn, you're not going to get it entirely without any hassle. No, it's going to be released tomorrow. So I'm just going to take this. Wow, he takes with the g pawn. Wow, that looks pretty bad, honestly. Giving me all those squares near the king. So let's open the position. Taking is basically impossible. So, yeah, e5, knight d7 is also bad. Queen is just exceptionally strong here. I can take e5 here, right? Yeah, Mikhtar says he does not know chessable. And that's something that will change then. Get to know it. It's good. Yeah, I think this will be a nice way to, this course will be a nice way for people to get to know the benefits of the platform. I mean, the chessable platform was added to the Play Magnus group some month ago, just as Chess24, and yeah, they knew what they were doing. I think I can definitely say it's a great platform. I publish all my courses there, and it I think works tremendously well to learn not just openings, but chess in general. We have all kinds of content on there. It's most of it is openings, but there are also end game courses, middle game courses. Yeah, for example, next week there will be the new Sam Shankland book, his second book will be released on Chessable first and then on then in print. Now, I should not get checkmated. That is a good general approach. I can go with the knight to f6. That looks like a good way to do it. Still a little bit annoying that I have to. Yeah, the woodpecker method is also unchessable. It's a very, this is a very well suited course for the chessable platform. Knight e4 is his idea. I thought I can just play rook h5, but he can take on h5, then shoot. Ah, holy moly. I've just got 4 seconds. Ah, and I have no sound. That is a big problem for me. Okay, so Lex managed to trick me there. My time was running down pretty much. Yeah, this was a big issue. All of a sudden, knight e4, and I spotted it very late that I can play just e5. Okay, now who's next in line here? Cobra? No, he's Cobra is a non-premium. That doesn't work. Let's play Schrummel then. Let's go Schrummel. Yeah, I mean, I would like to get the sound back, but I don't know how to turn off my messaging system, and I get messages every 5 minutes or so, and that wrecks me. How can I actually switch this off? It should be possible, right? How do I switch this off? Oh, that wasn't planned. Sorry, guys. So, I think now I'm getting rid of the messages and I have sound back. That's good. Okay, now let's get going here against Schrummel. Yeah, bishop f5. This is a good line going for queen d7 and bishop h3. Yeah, my rating is just like really, really low. Two 721. That's not good. Did any of you watch the Banter Blitz Cup before my show? There was this show with I think Praga. I cannot do it. Pragananda. It's not quite right, no. And who was he playing? Tari? I don't know who that was. I think it was Tari. Anybody watch that? Was it good? Yeah, so I managed to play this bishop h3, and but white played quick rook e1, so we am not trading the bishop. Yeah, it's probably a roughly equal position as I mentioned. Before I go b6. Yeah, I thought knight d4 should be fine, but maybe this isn't that great, but I don't really have a huge choice. Okay, I'm not going to repeat, so somebody People write the result in the chat. Maybe I shouldn't have started about this anyway. Pragnananda. Pragnananda. Okay. I'm still not good. For me, the weirdest part is always to have German words in there. When I all of a sudden have to change my mode, yeah, back to German, that is sometimes so difficult. Probably it's even worse if I have to talk about something that, yeah, I'm not sure about my idea here, but if I have to do even some other language in there, then there's a German in English and saying a French word or so. This is probably the absolute worst ever. Yeah, I thought that this should be okay for me, and this is probably a completely idiotic assumption because I cannot even get the e file. Rook a7, I can go rook a8. This is definitely okay for me. This is just going to be very drawish. Yeah, I'm not playing well. Yeah, it's just a complete draw. But, White can, of course, try something here with this pawn, but doesn't really. Shouldn't lead too much. Yeah, it's still going to be a draw. But he plays it in a very passive fashion. It's a little bit Zugzwang type. I promise I don't. I can just go here, right? It doesn't really. I should stop h4 first and foremost, and then I can go to h2 g1. Maybe I can actually be a bit of an annoyance there. It's still a draw. No, I'm getting the H3 pawn, which is at least something. Of course, still a draw, but it is an improvement on the earlier positions. So I need to get h5, I think. Now, is there anything that I can try here? If there is, it's related to invasion on the other side of the board. Okay. It's annoying. It's just annoying. What move? I'm getting d3 and things are getting a bit odd now. So thanks for the game, Schrummel. Okay, now who else is challenging me? Matekon Tomate 24. That's a really cool name. that made with a tomato or something. Could be. Yeah, but he's not playing. This is an issue. No move, no game. That's not good. Who else? ABB 65. ABB 65 is challenging me. So I'm going with this. Done very well with my D4 repertoire. And let's see what line ABB 65 is going for. Yeah, here bishop d7 is the main move, but I've encountered some others. C5 is possible. Knight c6 I've also seen, but I don't think this is so great. Okay. Queen d5 is usually what black is trying here. But just knight bd2 is better for white. If you don't call queen d5, this makes really yeah, not that much sense, honestly. No, sorry, I cannot play against non-premiums. It's just not allowed. I cannot do it. Okay, so a5, yeah, I don't know, b3 is possible. Okay, now I can take with the pawn or with the knight. I think I'll go with the knight. That makes e5 pretty much impossible. Well, this is a position where black is fairly solid, but cannot do much in active, as he cannot do much active things, or many active things. Now, what to do here? I wonder about the best possible placement for my pieces. Okay. I would like to get something going on the c file. Maybe I can get the knight to d3 and then double. He's playing this well. Just all moves make sense. Yeah, so that I probably have to take. Okay, now if I take on b4, he has a takes, right? But okay, I can play knight e5 for that pin. Okay, so he didn't do it. Now, if I go knight e5, is this maybe still a little something? Maybe. If he plays c5 at the end, I always have knight c4. So he's not doing that. So I'm just doubling now, probably. Yeah, so Rook D7. It's not very active, but it's still resilient. Do I get the knight traded somehow? Maybe get the king to E2 first. Knight e1 d3 now is my idea. Let's do it. If I get the knight to d3, he could of course retreat. Interesting. I mean, he can take and go e5 as well. Unsure. Okay, but I should not really take more time. Okay. So I'm going to step away from c5 or e5. Okay, this is interesting. That weakens Black's pawn structure quite a bit. Let's go here. Yeah, I don't know. I didn't think this would be helpful for him. Maybe he's got Rook A8 now. No, okay. I thought that would be good for me. Maybe I'm wrong. That's true. I wanted to go to e4. That is probably not going to happen. That's not so great. Not sure. Not sure here about this position. Okay, I cannot go. He cannot go forward. That's checkmate. So he has to go. Oh, I didn't think about this one. Didn't expect Rook C5. Wow, that's not great. Yeah, Black is just pushing here. With the king, I can take e5, but then king d3. I have a couple of dangerous looking pawns, but yeah, I don't know. I don't really have the time to work it out. Not well played, really. Pretty awful. Yeah, I can just run with the king. I have one on time. I didn't even realize that. I'm sorry. I didn't even see that I was ahead on time. I just played on. I didn't want to really flag here. Yeah, that was a pretty badly played game by me. Okay, thanks for playing ABB 65. Now, yet another non-premium. Comunio. Never played him before, so why not? What's Comunio going to do? D4, okay. Okay, I go d5 for a queen's gambit. And now for the Rogozin. Yeah, against e3, this is transposition now into a Nimzo-Indian. I'm going to play with b6. I think this is a pretty good line. And now bishop a6. Bishop e2 is a little bit uncommon. White usually plays the bishop to d3, but that should be okay as well. Okay, here, yeah, I'm happy to play this transformation. Now it would be great if I could manage this blockade on the light squares. Now, I think he more or less has to go c4 now. Otherwise, I go knight a5 just like that. This is not entirely clear to me if I'm okay here or not. I will play c5 shortly. Yeah, I would definitely like to keep this blockade going. Maybe I can do this, knight c4 and then b5. Yeah, I always try to play my recently released repertoires. It's there are common points there. Of course, it's a bit of an advertisement, I hope, but I also play the stuff that I currently know best. That's always what I've have written last. That's usually where my knowledge is best. But I also like to try it out. I'm just interested in yeah, seeing how it unfolds in real games. And here I'm not certain how if I did this too well. But it should be playable. I'm going knight e4 before he goes knight d2 and next a5. Get the pawns rolling. No. A good question here by the drunken lawyer. The question is if I still know all the lines that I had in for previous shows. No, I really have I mean, my memory is generally quite good, but it's just too much. There are just too many different openings and variations. Yeah, it is not possible for me to recall. I even have problems if you like on a real move by move basis to recall everything, even for the current things. Like the Magnus repertoire, I think I know almost anything, because that is so fresh in my mind, and I've recorded all the videos during the last couple of days. Why can I not take? I think I can take, right? Yep. The banner is a new course coming up tomorrow. So now let's roll the two pawns. They should be a lot quicker than White's Fd pawn. At least if I play it correctly. B2. B2 should do it. Yeah, I have Rook C4 C1. Nothing really that he can do about it. I mean, I also have A3 A2, of course. So Rook E2 doesn't do anything. Yeah, now it's probably too late. Yeah, Rook C4. And it's a touchdown or home run or something like that. Probably not a dunk, but something from baseball or football. That's not pre-move here. He has a spy check on b8. No, doesn't happen. Yeah, thanks for the game, Comunio. Yeah, you probably shouldn't have gone into this ending with the two pawns. That looks tough. Oh, let's play Chessie. Come on, Chessie. I'm only 10 points higher than you. That's fun. I mean, you're a good player, but 10 points is too. That difference is a bit too small. Okay. Valdis, I'm not quite sure what you're referring to. I've also written a D4 course, but the Magnus course is a Sicilian repertoire. So if you want something interesting against 1e4, this is the course for you. I wonder if I have blundered Bishop H6. Probably not. Yeah, this is a very sound approach here by Chessie, trading stuff. It's not something that worries Black a lot. Interesting. Now he has done something. This is a bit more. No, don't. Well, knight c7 is not a threat, but still. Knight e7 as rook e4, also not good. Or gain a bit of space. Okay. Not sure here. I think I should probably step away from the checks. It's probably pretty equalish. Yeah, maybe it's a bit easier for White. He can at least pretend that there's something, e4, rook cf8. Yeah, white is more active, for sure. I don't really see a particular threat. But the position is very symmetrical, but he's a bit more, he's got a bit more activity. There's a repertoire request for further further opening courses based a boring repertoire for both sides based on the Colley and French Ruinstein. I don't really think this is going to happen. People mostly want a more exciting subjects. And I have to confess that writing on more aggressive openings is also more fun. I had much fun doing the, he gives me the pawn, is that really such a great compensation? Let's say here, where is the compensation? I don't see it. Now, I don't think he gave away the pawn here on purpose. Knight e6 is the idea. I want to go back here anyway. And now, yeah, now I can go queen f5 for a trade. Yeah, should probably be right. No, when I record videos for opening courses, it's just usually one take. Sometimes we have to do something if there's a problem with my voice. That can happen. I had a severe cold. I was really annoying when I started to record, and then I need to do a bit of. There needs to be a bit of cutting. No, I usually just do one go. It doesn't. For the D4 repertoires, I didn't have any cuts. I mean, I just needed to because of the voice issues. So here I'm just getting the pawns rolling, 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 rolling. So take it, and now ready to play knight e5. Just stopping any king invasion, and that's not good. Okay. Gain a bit more space. Now I can trade. Yeah, thanks for the game, Chessy. Yeah, and sorry for the message that I had to send you. It doesn't work. So this was a more of a private message. I hope he listens. Now Kasparov fan, let's go. B3. Okay. In the recent issue of New in Chess magazine, there was a real opening article on B3 A5, and I just went for it. Not sure how good this really is, but why not? The issue, the idea must be to play a3, right? Or do we take here? I don't know. I only saw that the article was in there. I didn't read it. That can be a problem. So how do we play here? Maybe I can get knight to b4. I still have this issue to solve with the bishop on c8. Yeah, bishop to b7 next. It should be somewhat reasonable. It's a bit strange, this a5, but well, the spur of the moment decision. I wonder if white can go e4 here. That actually looks pretty, yeah, it looks right. I probably just go bishop b7 almost in any case. Bishop b2. Yeah, my issue here is simply that I don't quite know what to do with the queen. You can go c5 in such a position and just build up. I don't know. He always has knight a4. Let's do it. I don't like to have the pawn on c7 either. Yeah, there's a question here about the current situation in the league that I'm playing in, the Oberliga NRW. Is it called like that? They always keep changing stuff, but I think it is called still the Oberliga, the higher league. Yeah, there was one team withdrawing after the after everything was already set up. And I really hope that this club gets heavy fines for that. It's absolutely, for me, absolutely terrible. You cannot just, yeah, set up the team, yeah, and then like a week before it starts, they say, okay, we don't play. Yeah, and this is just I think a terrible way to behave and should be heavily fined. Now let's go c4. I mean, besides the annoyance value of such a procedure, you also, and this is the biggest concern, you have the problem that there are players in the team that are now in those they have them on their roster, but they cannot play anymore. Yeah, so these players have to basically wait a year and switch to a different club then. They probably get some. Yeah, I have this. Won the knight. They can maybe play some other games for that club, but it's still. It's just you don't do it like that. That's just a bad way to do it. I don't know what the reason is. They had also withdrawn from the Bundesliga the year before without any particular notice. Thanks for asking. And that's something that I have to tell you actually. The Hamburg Grand Prix, the Duda made it, right? Okay. I will actually do live commentary for the Hamburg Grand Prix. I completely forgot to tell. Yeah, I will do live commentary Friday, Saturday, and Sunday if there is a tiebreak. So make sure to check Chess24. I'll be doing the stream for Hamburg. I only today learned that I should do that. I'm happy to do it, of course. But this is all a little bit late notice, so we still try to get a co-commentator, co-host for me. But we don't have one yet, so I cannot tell you if I'm on there alone or somebody else will join me. It's not yet settled. It will be English language, so all of you should be able to tune in and understand what I'm saying. At least I try to make it understandable. Yeah, here there's just one check, I think. No, not even that. B8 I have covered. No, it's going to be English. It's going to be an English stream. Want to reach as many people as possible. Thanks for the game, Kasparov fan. Okay, now Chesobert is challenging. That's the guy with the green monster in the picture. I don't really know these relatively recent monster characters, probably from some kid movie. So let's try a bit of that Sicilian Magnus type repertoire. Probably I'm making a complete fool of myself, just screwing everything up and like... So this is nowadays a fashionable variation played here by Chesobert that was also played in the World Championship match. No! That was a mouse slip. I wanted to go A6. Okay. A6 is what I recommend. No. Okay. So how bad is it? I go B6. How bad is it? Maybe it's not so bad. Because in general, this setup isn't so bad. I want something like that, but usually you push the knight back first and then you play A5. This here is a little bit less comfortable. Okay, if I go knight C5, what is he doing then? C4? Maybe. Okay, F5 is part of the agenda here anyway. The general strategy in this line is that white has some pressure on the queen side. We see already the bishop d2 looks at a5, things like that. But I have some play on the other side of the board. And this is where I need to get some chances going. Now, if I take, I can probably take in this position. Bishop will take, go knight c5. It's a little bit annoying here, that mouse slip, because it's a big difference where the knight is positioned. Like from here, knight d4 is an option, obviously. And this is not happening if the knight is on a3. Yeah, it's just a different position. Now, I can take a4, right? Is that something? Why not? I mean, he gains a bit of time, but still, it's an important pawn. Yeah, there's a remark in the chat by Steiner Lima. Accidental novelty. Yeah, I actually think that happens pretty often. That those novelties that are sometimes praised by... Yeah, chess annotators or other people, yeah, they're just slips. I think this is happening quite frequently. When some line was planned and then somehow you don't get it right. And play a novelty by accident. Yeah, here the issue is that the knight, if it moves, that runs into knight c3. Yeah. Okay, I still think I'm going to take on b5. Rook takes and then knight c5 back. Still under a bit of pressure, but I think rook c5 d takes is a tempo. I think one important point here is that his bishop on f3 is really not in any good shape. And I have a fairly simple plan now. A4, A3, A2, queen the pawn. It's good to have a simple plan, in particular in blitz chess. Makes you a fast player. Normally, if you have a clear-cut plan, what to do? Yeah, also bishop f6. So maybe rook c5 is what he wants to do. Sorry, rook c5 takes d6. That looks like that is that he wants to do it. Okay, I think I can go bishop f6 here. Knight was hanging. Why? No, please don't tell me stuff like that. The knight was not hanging. Or what? Sorry. That irritates me to no end. The knight was hanging. How can it hang when it is on c5, anchored by a pawn? Now the A pawn should do the job. Yeah, or this one. All right, thanks for the game, Chesobert. Yeah, that was an awful mouse slip. But maybe A5 gets played soon by any of the top players. Queen d4, the knight wasn't hanging, right? I took here, right? I took on b5, so I don't think it was hanging. Okay, anyway, let's go to the next game and see who is challenging me. What about Pirinos Floga? Why not? Yeah, I went bishop f6 later, right? So let's go e4 for a change. And see what Pirinos is doing. Okay, e5. Yeah, I can play my old recommendation from the e4 repertoire. The Scotch Four Knights. I'm a bit rusty there in the theoretical department. But, yeah, these positions are usually quite easy to play. You develop in a very healthy fashion. And it's not very likely that you screw it up in one move. Okay, here probably prepare c4. Black usually gets very close to equality in this line, but you can still try a little bit. Pose small problems. Okay, now he wants to take on c4. I can still take here, right? Takes, knight takes. Yeah, so here rook e8, rook e8, rook c4. Yeah, it's a somewhat better ending, right? So if I take here, I don't really like the D-pawn to be so active. Maybe I can do it like that. Oh, okay. Didn't expect this one. He just goes into this ending a pawn down. I didn't think that was necessary yet. Tja, the winning chances here are relatively small. I have to somehow get an invasion of the king going up to support the pawn. It's going to be difficult, really, to do. Have to advance it. I actually could have switched the rook over. It was a miss. I should have tried that. This is, generally speaking, quite a favorable structure for white on the king side. So, and then try to switch over. Offer me a draw. No, I don't take that yet. Probably cannot make a breakthrough right that side of the board. No. He's offering me a draw again. Sorry, that makes no sense. No player, absolutely no player in the world gives you a draw in this position. It might be a draw, but it just doesn't happen that people, accept an offer there. I still have to say that I don't quite see a way forward here. Probably there isn't a way forward. Sometimes you have to keep the pawn on a6 to have a king to a7 available. Maybe I should have done that. It's definitely possible. I also cannot escape there to e8, unfortunately. Sometimes you can escape to e8. Yeah, this is a key idea, yeah, that he can do that. F4, unfortunately, he's checking me on a5, and this is not going to do anything. Yeah, that's probably just a draw. Okay. Maybe I retain some winning chances if I have the pawn on a6. That is possible. Wasn't quite sure in this position. But yeah, I think well defended here by him. Now, Daniel 2005 is challenging me. That's an interesting player. This is Daniel Dada, he's the current champion of Belgium, I think. And he's young, 2005 is the birth year. Okay, an Alapin. Wow, why is that a move? Now that line I have never seen, interesting. Interesting situation here, really. My development is a little bit off, but strategically speaking, this looks very very good. I have good outposts here for the knights. Don't want knight g5 to be annoying. It's a fairly drawish position. Pretty typical for the c3, for the Alapin. It's often fairly drawish. Yeah, I wonder if I can do something here or if it's just going to be equal. Probably just going to be equal. Okay. That is a little bit annoying here, right? Rook c2 is a threat and rook c1 doesn't work. Knight d4 is rook d5. That wins immediately. So rook c2, king d1, rook f2. What's the deal? What's the deal? Yeah, rook d1, rook f2. This is even worse, right? Now I can check him first and then take. It's probably even better, huh? Check first, then take the pawn. Now here, yeah, the e5 pawn is also going to be weak. But if I just go here, going to be difficult for him to cover here, right? He wants to go to c5, that I can stop. Yeah, I wanted to go f5, but that is not working that well here. I just recognize that b2 is, of course, just hanging. So this is also something that I could have done. But, of course, I don't mind this ending. So f6. Now the knight should go to f5 if possible. It's actually not super clear if that is so great. Ja. So, King F4 didn't work. Now, or just E5 is also good, right? I got some options there to continue. This looks like white doesn't have much counterplay. That seems attractive. Now, anything what he can do, knight g7 or something? I should just get this. Oh, I didn't see this. I didn't see that b5 was hanging. That's a bit stupid. It still wins, but wasn't exactly the most precise way to play. I thought e2 now, but he's got knight d4 check, right? Anyway, I have to play. It's not the best technical play that was possible, for sure. Yeah, I go King B2 next. Cannot stop the pawn anymore. Yeah, I didn't do this well, technically speaking, but it was okay for the most part. Yeah, thanks for the game, Daniel 2005. I got many non-premium challenges, yeah. So Be Faster is the next game. It's actually a 5-minute game. Huh, okay, that's a bit too long. So I have to play quickly to not be largely too late. So dashing out some quick moves, yeah. Bit of a strange version here of a Tarrasch. It is a Tarrasch, but with black having a somewhat odd setup. Now he just gave me c5. This is nice. Very generous. Now queen c5, rook c1 seems good, and c6 is hanging. So probably cover this with the queen, maybe queen c3 next. Okay, Bishop a3 was not my intention. But okay, I want to keep the pawn. I'm actually not such a materialistic player, but if you give me something for free, I don't want to return it so easily. Okay, now this means I can put the bishop back. At least I can try. So I managed to keep that. Yeah, I wonder, come on. I just snack this and go Queen C3. Got a couple of threats against against G7 now, which he has stopped. But I think this should still be pretty good for White. The bishop on A7 really looks like a sad piece. And of course, I had to give up my fianchettoed bishop, but my king is still safe. So it's always important to check this. If you give up the bishop there, it can be extremely shaky. Yeah, bishop on A7 is just dead. No, at some point B5 should do the trick. No, let's do it. Pawn takes C6. Yeah, that's a win. All right, really? What is the big point? Rook takes, I guess. Wants to go Queen D7, Queen G4, something like that. But still looks pretty much winning. I can play F3 maybe, yeah, first. Kick this rook away. So that there's no queen g4, eh? Something like that. It's now out of the picture. Yeah, unfortunately, I'm a little bit late for the German show. Maybe some of you will probably also join the German show. Maybe you can just briefly post in the chat that I'm on in a couple of minutes because I'm still in this game and want to finish it properly. I made a bit of a mistake to accept a 5-minute challenge. I should have clicked on a 3-minute challenge, but I didn't. It didn't register at the time when I was clicking. Okay, now he will take next queen takes B7. No, it's probably best for rook A8. Rook A8. To try and bishop g3? I don't believe it. No. Not going to happen. Now, how to do this? And not allowing any big counterplay. I can probably simply queen, yeah? Bishop h2? No, go to h1. No. Bishop h2, king h1. I don't see much happening here. Nope. It's probably time to. Yep. Yeah, thanks for the game. Be faster. Yeah, a little bit later here than originally planned. I hope you enjoyed the English Banter Blitz show. And if you're watching it live tomorrow, my new opening repertoire is going to be released, Fight Like Magnus. Have a look if you're interested. All right, and then I'm back for coverage for the Hamburg Grand Prix starting Friday. So I'm going to cover the final. Yeah, thanks a lot for watching. Till, in a couple of minutes, till Friday, I'll be on quite a bit. Bye-bye.